Good afternoon and welcome back to Buster Boom. Today we take on Aldershot in the first round of the FA Cup with a chance to play Maidenhead in the second round at home. Feasibly, we could make it to the third round of the FA Cup here, which means we could get one of the big boys and say going to Old Trafford. That could set us up for the entire save. A million odd pound for going there. And you know what? We could walk into League Two with that, I reckon. But then, and then we take on Gloucester. You know, not to take away from the glamour there, but Gloucester away from home. And things aren't all rosy at Darlington at the moment. Schedule-wise, we've only played the one game against Brackley since you were last with us. It was a 1-1 draw. It wasn't great. We got a penalty. We should have won at the end. We had more chances. Henry had a bad game. We missed an absolute sitter in the last couple of minutes to win it. But yeah, we still are top of the league on goal difference with Chester. Although we do have a game in hand on them. Blythe are up there again, Boston. File have dropped back a little. I say dropped back a little, but they're 2 points behind us. They drew an extra game. And we do have some complaining in the team. And a new signing. So complaining-wise, who is whining? Who's on the moan? Where's he gone? Dan Maguire come and complained. He's not playing enough, so he's on the transfer list. And he rejected a chance to go play for Ebbsfleet in Division above. But bizarre, I know. Saltmer had a moan, and he is now on the transfer list. Blackpool won him. That's a bit... He can't be that good, can he? Blackpool? I don't know. I don't know what's going on there. Anyway, we have signed an absolutely baller of a player. And Gesson came up on my scout list and I thought, I've got to have this boy. £450 a week. Free transfer. Coach Report says he's a good player for most National League sides. You know, we're in Division below, so he's obviously a leading player for us. And potentially a good Sky Bet League 2 player in the future. So, no-brainer. He could be one that goes all the way up to League 2 with us. That's if I don't get sacked on the way. Team Report, where is it? I want to see if he's actually made it into... we don't have any players in this, the Media Dream 11. Now, David Perkins is there, funnily enough. Ex-Tramia. Again, he's a good player. He's 38. I always thought he was a great player for Tramia. Natural fitness, 16, look at that. Pace 7 now. Actually, I've got a little scout of him. He's a file now. No wonder they're doing well. We haven't even got any players in the key players we have. Well, there he is, Henry. And there's a guest in there. Luke Charman's there, who is nearly back, by the way, which would be absolutely massive. So, team-wise, we're struggling a little bit. And Gesson's had to come straight in, unfortunately, because we're missing... Charman's obviously away still. Henry is on international duty, bizarrely. It's only Nigeria on the 20s, but that's where he's gone. Atkinson's injured. And Hatfield's suspended, who would normally sit in the midfield. So, and Gesson's coming in, and he's not really fit, and it's not ideal, and as is Rivers, who isn't really fit. I have no real choice, though. I mean, I'm looking at... Who else? Theo Hudson. He's not very good. Who else? Holmes. Again, not very good. Rivers is the best of those. And then Gesson is obviously the best midfielder at the club at the moment. So, we're just having a grin and bear it. You know, I still think we're good enough to be getting through against Aldershot. You know, Aldershot are usually a decent team. You look at their team there. James Rowe, ex-Tramia. And Tanner's there. Tom Sawes is playing for them. I mean, it's a decent team. Mitch Walker in goal. Good goalkeeper. And it's a decent team, but I think we built a mid-table National League team here. It was already a good team. We just added a few good players to it. So come on, lads. Show what you can do. Keep our run going. Yeah, we'll say that. Well, nobody cared. How big of an absence is Henry due to an international? Yeah, it's a big absence, but my assistant can take that. I am not talking to the media. It seems just a bit of a faff. Oh, by the way, you can do this. I didn't know. I learned this today. That's how you get it back to there. Now, I need to set up the tablet a bit. Hang on. Are we going to score here? Oh, that is a really poor finish from Sousa. There's a block in there, but it didn't look like it. Corner into the box. It's headed away. Now, I've yet to see a corner scored in this save. So, if you are having problems with goals going in from corners, let me know. I don't mean just me scoring them. I don't see the opposition score them either. The problem with this is, even if... Hang on, we'll do it in a second. McMahon, ball to the back post, and it's a goal. Now, it wasn't a corner, before you say. And Rivers, who was just saying, is a bit knackered, has scored the goal. Why can't corners do that? Ball to the back post, Rivers gets up. In fact, it's Ogie who misses the ball. He's much bigger. So anyway, you can drag this out like this, but it doesn't stay that way, which is a bit of a pain. I wonder if you can lock that. Tanner, corner into the box. See if they score a corner now. I am raging. They hit the post. Why can't it? Like, can we keep it like that? Is there any way to just lock it? It stays like that for the moment. But it doesn't. Look, Rivers is knackered and they're asking for Holness to come on. Like, we're only in the first half. Anyway, all the shot. It's James Rowe with the ball. You know what? I called out James Rowe and Tanner before the game started and they combined and score a goal. James Rowe was always a good player for Tranmere. He just wasn't really given much of a chance. And Tanner never played with Tranmere, but he seems to see a lot of the ball, James Rowe. Again, look at the XG. We're the better team here. 7 shots, 2 on target. I reckon if we had a... Get back out there and grab a goal. I reckon if we had our full team. If we had Henry and Charman playing, we are ripping these apart. Why won't you stay that way? Can someone tell me how to keep the tablet like that? Is it in settings? No, it's not. View all match preferences. It's not. You know what? I'll have a look later. I'll have a look when I play in other games rather than subjecting you to it. Story, ball forward, Campbell's in. It's a goal. He's offside. I come up very quickly with disallowed there. Is he offside? Yeah, he is. Yeah. Whoa. It was a good finish. It was like a scissor kick. He's struggling, wants to substitute it. We're going to have to get him off, aren't we? Now, I do have a plan. You know what we'll do? We'll get Dan Maguire on from, and we'll swap them two round. Dan Maguire's moaned. He can be a poacher. He's a decent poacher, you know, but he's just not going to get in the team. Campbell's better player, and Sharman's even better than them. And Guessing is struggling. Now, is there a replay? I don't want a replay. Come on, boys. 12 shots, only 3 on target. Wheatley gets it out wide to Campbell. He's a better in this position. Ball into the box. Maguire, what did he do? Put it back out? Why would he do that? McMahon's there anyway. Puts it into Denny. Denny to Guessing. He's at the bar. That would have been some debut to put us through to the second round of the FA Cup. Walker clings onto it. We nearly even headed the rebound in. Pumps it forward. Do not let them score in the last 30 seconds after we hit the bar. Tanner's there, but never mind. Little picks it up. Can we get it forward? 20 seconds of a shot on goal here. And Guessing into Denny. Denny to Maguire. Maguire holds onto the ball. Gives it out to Souza. Souza down the wing. Get the ball into the box. It's out for the throw-in. Is it really going to show me that highlight of the ball going off the throw-in? Little. Souza, he's flicked it on, he's offside, isn't he? He's Bouncey. We're having extra time. We are having extra time, right. Dressing room, it's time to dig in. It is time to dig in, but we need to get Guessing off. He is absolutely goosed. What am I going to do here? Henley, you're coming on for Guessing. Headley it is. And you're going to have to be an absolute baller here. Oh, he's not good at anything, is he? He's just going to have to do it. He's going to have to come in and be a hero. It goes to penalties as well, doesn't it? Oh, no, Tanner. Ball into the box. It's headed away. Campbell, can he get there first? He can. Campbell is away. Down the left wing. Cut inside. Campbell, finish that. No. Oh, it was such a good chance. 40, we're so much better than these. Yes, just... Oh, stories. I don't care about suspensions. Right, second half of extra time here. Now, I've no idea how good we are at penalties, by the way. So this could be an absolute disaster. Ogie to Edsa. Is that Frank Newbley? He's another one from... He was at West Ham originally and then hung around League 1 and League 2 like a bad smell for a long time. But Story picks it up to Little. Souza cuts inside. Gives the ball away. Look at the size of me. Huge new blade. Tanner with the shot. It's off the bar. Oh. Bet you didn't think we were going to get a penalty shootout, did you? Right. We are the better team. We should have won it. Calm ahead. Displaying little emotion. See, I like that. Come on, lads. Show me what you can do. Oh, don't do this to me. Right, guy I can't pronounce steps up, plants it straight down the middle, keep the dives out the way. Right, Wheatley, you've scored every penalty so far. You've had two. Put this one away for me. Wheatley steps up and he does. Good lad, Wheatley. Our normal penalty taker there. Tanner. I always believe you should put your best penalty takers first. Because if you do that badly in the shootout, you won't get to your last ones. So put the boys up, we're going to score first. McMahon steps up. Old head on his shoulders, puts it away. Good lad, McMahon. Right, Frank Newblake, look at the size of him. Big chungus. Steps up. Come on, Reese. Straight down the middle. I wouldn't have gotten in the way of that. I'm with you there, Reese. I would not get in the way of that. Right, Campbell. Steps up. Good penalty from Campbell, that. He's a ginger sensation, isn't he? Right, Reese steps up. Come on. That's going to save in. He saved it. Good lad. Oh, excellent save. Right, Souza. Two penalties scored, and we're in the second round of the FA Cup. There's the first one. Now, all the shots have to score here, or we are going through to face Maidenhead at home, who aren't as good as Aldershot. Aldershot. I can't speak. I've got a big ulcer on my lip here, and it's really annoying me, and it's affecting the way I talk at the moment. That's my excuse. Okay, leave my speech impediment alone. Edsa steps up. Can he save another? Oh, it's just into the bottom corner. Right, who's coming up here? I didn't look. I tend not to. I let the assistant do this. Oh, it's Denny. Denny, on loan from Salford. Excellent footballer. Can he put it away for us? This boy could be a League One central midfielder. Steps up, puts it away, and there we are. Into the second round, the FA Cup, against Maidenhead. I'm made up with that. And we get a nice chunk of money for this as well. Good boy. No, I'm very pleased with your result and performance. They're a team above us, you know, in the league above us. So that's two teams we knocked off from the league above. I am made up with that. Right. So let's see how much money we get. We do get a bit of money for this, don't we? 22 grand. You can't complain at that, can you? That's going to pay for them guessing this year. Darlington, 22 grand. Darlington draw Maidenhead in the second round. Look at that. We're a Maidenhead in the league. 10th in the National League. We're Aldershot. 13th. You know, they're only a point ahead of Aldershot. You know what? Full team, we're doing them. We're getting to the third round. Although we do lose McMahon and Hunt, which is going to be a big problem. We've lost half our back line there. Great. So, and I want to show you this as well, very quickly. Schedule-wise, is our game now that we're going to show you is in 2 days' time. As in, this is still the same day we just played Aldershot. You know, a day after each other, it's just mad. Mad scheduling. I don't understand why. So we'll have to rest them for a day. Maybe they don't have training anyway, but we'll give them a day's rest. Right, boys, training-wise, rest. A day. I'll click on, and I'll see you all back for... I forgot who we're playing now. Is it Gloucester? The Gloucester game. See you in a second. Welcome back then for the Gloucester game. We do have some very tired players. Denny's knackered, McMahon's knackered, Souza's knackered, and Gesson's knackered, but so's Wheatley. So I brought Hatfield back in, who's no longer suspended, for Wheatley there. And what I'll do is I'll bring Wheatley on for Gesson when it gets a bit too much. Souza's just going to have to play. He's just going to have to like it. And McMahon, do I have a right back? Adam Senior can come on for McMahon at some point. And we have Headley there as well that can come on for him. I think Headley's a better right back than he is midfielder. He is. Weird that it says he's natural midfielder. But he's just bad at it. Maybe that's just the way it is. I mean, I was a better right winger. I used to have played at left back sometimes. Anyway, enough of that. And Gesson's not fully fit. Yeah, I know he isn't, but baptism of fire here. Do I know any Gloucester players? I'd be surprised if I did. Kevin Dawson, maybe. No. Asante? Yeah, I do know Asante. Tell you what. It's a who's who of Ghost of Vanarama National League past, isn't it? Come on, lads, show me what you can do. Yeah, we'll say that. We'll say that. Again, I think this could be our first defeat of the season, to be honest. Can I show... There's the league table there now. There we go, that's what I wanted to see. I'm going to have to keep doing that every time I come in here, though, but... It's a bit of a pain. Ball into the box, and it's disallowed offside. Thank God for that. Gloucester, we'll have a quick look here where they are in the league. He's miles offside, don't need to see it again. Gloucester are mid-table. so not doing too bad. Gateshead are really struggling. So are Kettering. McMahon into the back post. And it is disallowed for offside as well. Excellent start to the game. Two disallowed goals. No excitement at all. We're 27 minutes in. We've had two highlights, both disallowed. He is miles offside. Is he one scores it? Why is it flagging him offside? He wasn't interfering with play at all. Oh, is that Bernard Mensah? Okay, I do know Bernard Mensah. McClaw, and it's a good save by Taylor. Rhys Taylor has been an inspired signing. Considering he put us through in the cup there as well. Headed over the bar. Bernard Mensah down at Gloucester. He was a good player. I thought he was a great player for... It is. He played for Aldershot, was he? Yeah, Aldershot. And then he went to Bristol Rovers. You know what? We're going to scout him. In fact, I think he already has. I got to have some quick look at him quick. See if I can get... Is he on a non-contract? Never mind. Campbell, down the wing. Ball into the box. It's cleared away. Little heads it back. Souza and Gesson. Denny. Out to Souza. Souza cuts inside. Has a shot. Oh, that would have been an absolute belter as well. Right, I want to have a quick look at Bernard. It's half time. Great. I'm not going to get to. I might want to nick him. I still want to know why our goal was disallowed. We've had more of the ball. Same XG. Interesting game. Interesting game. You know what? We are going to point the finger and say I'm not happy with performance out there. It seemed to motivate them. That's the best I can ask for, really, isn't it? Let's click his name before there's a highlight. 72. He is considered a 4-star potential ability. How old is he now? Don't know. I might try and nick him if he's on a non-contract, but I doubt it. Again, if I think a couple of Tranmere fans are watching this, they will remember Bernard Mensah from Aldershot. He played in the playoff semi-final against us, at especially at Prendon Park. Was he the boy that scored the amazing goal for them to put them 2-1 up or 1-1? It may have been. All our players are struggling now. We're 80 minutes in, and now we've lost Gesson to injury. That's a bit of a blow. Hatfield will come in as the box-to-box midfielder, though. Souza is knackered. Do I have anyone to come on for him? Not really. Hudson. You know what? Dan Maguire's coming on again. We're going to draw our second game in a row, aren't we? We have to do that. We're just going to have to do that. 0-0. It's going to knock us off the top, it is. York have overtaken us. So it's not all plain sailing, this. We haven't won in 3 games now. And I have to say, I'm a bit disappointed. I'm not happy with that, boys. I am not happy. We haven't lost yet, okay, but... You know, 14 points from 6 is not the worst. You know, media prediction is now 4th. I don't know, I'm not happy. And Gesson's out for 2 to 3 days. I can live with that. Let's rest them for a couple of days, shall we? Because they're all knackered. It doesn't help. There's this little silly thing. Training, rest, 2 days. There we go. Right, when do we come back? When is this Maidenhead game? Because that's when we're coming back, obviously. That's what I'm going to do then. York, obviously, are top of the league at the moment. So we're going to come back for York Maidenhead. When's the FA Trophy? FA Trophy, you've got Boston. Great. So York and Maidenhead with the possibility to get into the third round. That'd be amazing, wouldn't it? First season, third round of the FA Cup. Brilliant. Listen, if you are enjoying this, leave me some comments. Talk away to me in the comments section. I get loads of views, but just talk away. I enjoy a good debate. Like, subscribe. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you all again tomorrow.